Hey guys, it's Luke with CZUSA, and today I'm going to show you how to remove a few parts from this new Scorpion 3 Plus. These are common parts that a lot of people like to either swap out with aftermarket parts from other companies. So I'm going to show you how to properly do that, and then I'm going to show you how to reinstall them as well. So to start, just like any other time working on a firearm, I always want to check and make sure it's clear. So I'll go ahead and remove the mag. So we've checked, make sure it's clear. I'll set that off to the side. I'm going to go ahead and start and just kind of work front to back. So we're going to start with the muzzle device. This gun comes with a flash can. There's really no special tool to take this off. You're going to see these two notches in the end. Any rigid tool that will fit in there will work just fine. Obviously, you want to make sure it fits fairly tight so you don't, you know, damage the muzzle device in any way. What I've got here is just a standard AR armorer's wrench. It's about the same thickness as those notches. So I'm just going to go ahead and stick it in there. And then just rotate. Should pop loose. And then you can go ahead and just thread it off, just like any other muzzle device. And then threads back on the same way. There's no crush washer or anything like that because the muzzle device doesn't need to be timed any specific way. So it just direct threads right onto the barrel. So I'm going to go ahead and screw that back on. When reinstalling, you obviously want to make sure it's fairly tight. You can go ahead and apply a drop of red Loctite on it if you would like. You know, obviously the barrel is going to get hot. You want to check and make sure, especially after you've removed it and you've reinstalled it. After a few rounds, a couple of magazines, you'll want to check and make sure it's still tight. But as long as you torque it on there pretty tight, you should be just fine. All right, from there, I'm going to go ahead and work on the charging handle. So to do this, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to disassemble it real quick. I'm going to lock the bolt back. I'm going to pull the trigger pack off. The only reason I'm doing this is because I'm going to take the bolt out and I'm going to take all the pressure off the charging handle. It's going to make it a little bit easier. So obviously this is a non-reciprocating charging handle. It's not actually attached to the bolt. It just rides in front of it. So you can use it to manually pull the bolt back if you need to. So to get this out, there is a small polymer pin in the front of the handguard. It goes through the front here. The smaller head is the one you want to push on and push away from. So I'm just going to go ahead and use one of my Allen wrenches here. And I'm going to go ahead and push on that. And it's just held in there with a little bit like a polymer detent built onto the pin. So there's a little bit of a click to it to hold it in place, but it's pretty easy to overcome. So you just go ahead and push it out that way and pull it out. You can see that pin has that little bump on it. That is important. When you reinstall that, you're going to want to make sure that little bump goes towards the rear, back towards you. Now that that's out, push the charging handle forward. You're going to get to a spot where it feels like it wants to stop. Now there is a small little spring detent built into the charging handle. And this part's important because if you just pull it and try to get it past that without pressing on it, you can damage that little clip and make it really difficult to remove. So I'm going to take the same Allen wrench, punch, whatever you're using that I used to push that pin out, and I'm going to stick it through this hole on the other side. And if you look down in there, you can see the little silver piece. And you're going to want to push on that. At the same time, you're going to push the charging handle out. You can see that little nub right there is what I was talking about. So you want to make sure you push that in, get the charging handle out, and then you can go ahead and install it on the other side. And when you're putting it back in, you actually don't have to push that little tab in. It's pretty easy to overcome the spring tension. You can just go ahead and slide it back in. Once the charging handle's back in, you're going to go ahead and reinstall that pin. Like I said, make sure this little nub on the top goes back towards you to the rear of the gun. And it doesn't matter which direction it goes in, it's ambidextrous, goes either way. And then just push it in until you feel a little click. And that's pretty much it for that. Then you can go ahead, reinstall. I'm gonna go ahead and leave this stuff out because I got a few more things to show you. But at that point, if that was all you were doing, you could go ahead and reinstall the bolt and the trigger pack. The next thing I'm gonna show you is I'm gonna show you how to remove the grip. So for this, it's actually a 2.5 millimeter Allen. There's one screw right here. It goes all the way through the receiver and it rides in a slot between the receiver halves. So I'm gonna go ahead and loosen that up. So that's loose, you can pull that out, and then the grip should just slide back off the two receiver halves. You can see that kind of elongated notch there. The reason they do that is because you can actually adjust it just slightly. If you don't want it to sit all the way forward, give you your finger a little different purchase on the trigger, you can adjust to put that back on. Same process, slide it back on those grooves. You're gonna see two different sides of this grip. This one obviously has the threaded nut. And this one has the recess for the screw. So you wanna make sure the bolt goes in the correct direction from left to right. And then we're gonna tighten it back down. And you're gonna know you're tight enough when the screw starts to protrude the other end. Another piece of the gun, you don't wanna over tighten, but you'll know when you go far enough when that screw starts to protrude out the other side of the grip. So, next thing I'm gonna show you is, this is a pretty common one. People like to install, if you wanted to install a brace or if you've SBR'd it and you wanna install stock, taking the rear head off. So there is a detent built into the receiver halves, and you have to push it down and then push the head up at the same time. You always wanna make sure you go up off the receivers. That is very important. It will not go down, and you'll damage it if you try to. So another thing you wanna know is you wanna make sure you use the biggest punch possible to fit in this bottom hole. That detent button in there is polymer, and if you use a punch that's too small, you can actually push through it if you're pushing too hard. It does not take a lot of force. That's a common mistake too, and if you actually go through the detent, that can cause issues. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna use the same Allen wrench. And a lot of times these rear heads are pretty tight on the polymer receivers. So if you push down on that, you can feel a little bit of spring tension. So just push down until it stops. There's no need to go any farther than that. And then while it's pushed down, I'm gonna use nylon mallet. And I'm just gonna get it started, and you can see it only moved not even an eighth of an inch. So that's enough to hold the detent down while I push it the rest of the way off. So slide it up, and that's pretty much it. So you can see that button there. It's pretty big. Obviously the hole in the rear head is a lot smaller. But like I said, you wanna make sure it's the biggest punch you can find that will fit in there, which I believe is like a 5/32, somewhere in there. That way you won't run the risk of actually punching through the detent trying to push too hard. To reinstall, you're gonna go ahead, same way it came off, you're gonna go down from the top, and I'm gonna push down until I get to that detent button. I'm gonna push it in, push past slightly, and you see I kind of got to a point where it's a little bit tight there, so I'm just gonna go ahead and take my nylon mallet and go until it stops. You don't have to hit it that hard. Usually some of them are tighter than others. Polymer molding can do that. But a little nylon mallet, a couple of taps, should come off just fine. All right, I'm gonna set the gun off to the side, and the last thing I'm gonna show you is how to remove the safety levers in case you wanna put on like a safety delete kit, one of the AK style safeties, one of the aftermarket options, something like that. So to do that, you're gonna wanna make sure first the gun is in fire. So right now it's in safe, and there's these two grooves right up here that go down into the safety levers. Now you can't access the set screws that hold these levers on if it's on safe. So with the trigger pack out, you wanna make sure when you put it on fire, you wanna make sure you keep your finger off the trigger. Otherwise you'll send the hammer forward, might pinch a finger or something like that. So we're gonna go ahead and put it on fire, and then now you can see that there's actually a set screw lined up with the little groove in the trigger pack itself. So we're gonna take a 1.5 millimeter Allen, and we're gonna put it in there. We're just gonna take those screws out. And once those screws are out, there's just one on each side, and it's the same process for both sides. Once that screw is out, that little safety lever will pop right off. And you'll just see that right there, which is the actual safety bar itself. Like I said, same process for the other side, if you wanted to do them both or one or the other. I do recommend a little bit of blue Loctite when you reinstall these. Just a small drop, it'll go a long ways, help those screws from backing out. If they back out far enough, it could possibly make the safeties not be able to function. So to reinstall, just go ahead and slip that paddle back over the safety bar. And then you're gonna line up the hole for the set screw with the groove in the trigger pack. I'm gonna take my set screw. You wanna make sure you go in all the way, or like I said, if it sticks out too far, you could possibly, you know, make the safety inoperable because the screw will hit that groove in the trigger pack. So I'm just gonna snug this back down. And we're all set. So now I can turn it back to safe. And we should be all set there. So now I'm gonna go ahead and finish reassembling. I'm gonna put the bolt back in the gun. Lock the bolt up, the charging handle and notch there. Put the rear of the trigger pack in, push it up, and we're all set. And that's pretty much it. So for more information, go ahead and check out czusa.com and follow us on social media.